Donald Trump and the Republican-controlled Congress moving full speed ahead with an ambitious agenda. Confirmation hearings begin tomorrow for some of the president-elect's key cabinet nominees. While the Senate is expected to hold a series of votes this week to begin repealing Obamacare, but details of replacing the outgoing president's signature law still remain unclear.
It may take time to get all the elements of the replace in place.
Trump will also finally answer questions on Wednesday when he holds his first press conference in nearly 6 months. The now declassified intelligence report on Russian hacks expected to be a major focus, but questions remain about whether Trump accepts the report's conclusions.
He's not denying that entities in Russia and it were behind this particular hacking campaign.
Hillary Clinton was viewed by a majority of Americans as unlikable. That has nothing to do with Moscow.
Over the weekend, Trump tweeting, "Having a good relationship with Russia is a good thing, not a bad thing. Only stupid people or fools would think that it is bad. When I am president, Russia will respect us far more than they do now. And both countries will perhaps work together to solve some of the many great and pressing problems and issues of the world." For months, Trump has cast doubts about U.S. intelligence that Russia was trying to interfere with the election.
It could be somebody else.
Maybe there is no hacking. Could be Russia, but it could also be China. Could also be lots of other people. It also could be somebody sitting on their bed that weighs 400 pounds.
Trump's skepticism dividing his own party.
If after having been briefed by our intelligence leaders, Donald Trump is still unsure as to what the Russians did, that would be incredibly unnerving to me because the evidence is overwhelming.
In a new interview, President Obama says he did not downplay the threat Vladimir Putin posed to the United States.
I don't think I underestimated him. Vladimir Putin's not on our team. If we get to a point where people in this country feel more affinity with a leader who is an adversary and views the United States and our way of life as a threat to him, then we're going to have bigger problems than just cyber hacking.